LNG TV, the official media channel partner for Gastech 2021.
Well, I am delighted to be joined by His Excellency Udaya Gamanpila, who's the Minister of Energy in Sri Lanka. Thank you so much for joining us here on LNG TV. Firstly, how are you enjoying Gastech, and why was it important that Sri Lanka were represented here?
Of course, this is very interesting, informative, and we are interacting with a lot of people because Sri Lanka, firstly, we are about to join the petroleum producing club because we had a lot of gas and oil reserves, but because of the internal conflicts, terrorist activities, we couldn't tap those. Now we are about to commence producing gas and oil in Sri Lanka. So I want to share that news with the petroleum and gas community in the world. Secondly, Sri Lanka, being an island in a tropical zone, especially in close proximity to the equator, has a huge potential for wind, solar and hydro. So we are in a position to produce excessive wind and hydro electricity and turn it to green hydrogen. And we are in a position to be a hydrogen exporter in the near future. So we want to develop Sri Lanka as the hydrogen hub of Asia. So that's our dream. So we wanted to share our dream with the rest of the world.
Because currently, at the moment, what sort of percentage of Sri Lanka energy is come from renewables, and why does that put you in a good position to, as you say, become one of the leading players with hydrogen?
Well, Sri Lanka is in a peculiar situation when the world is planning to shift from petroleum to renewable. We are about to tap our own resources, but on the other hand, until 1996, Sri Lanka's electricity was fully produced with renewable energy sources, mainly around 95% hydropower. Because of the severe drought we faced in 1996, we had to gradually introduce thermal power such as diesel, coal and fuel oil power plants. Now we are going back to, at the moment, renewable energy share of our power mix is 35%, from 100% to 35% during the last 25 years. Now we are going to, reverse trend. We are going to make it 70% by 2030 and 100% by 2050. 2050, of course, the global target. So we have also planned to meet that target by 2050. We can quite possible. Then, because of our huge renewable potential, when you say the Sri Lanka, it comes to the mind that 65,000 square kilometer, relatively small island. But Sri Lanka's location is unique. There is no single country to the west of Sri Lanka until Somalia. Similarly, no single country to the east until Malaysia. From south, of course, until Antarctica, there is no single country. Because of that, Sri Lanka's exclusive economic zone, 9 times of its land territory. Sri Lanka's continental shelf, 23 times of land territory. This huge area is for Sri Lanka to produce renewable energy. That's why we are planning to produce hydrogen. At this moment, Sri Lanka is an energy importer. We import all petroleum products from other countries, including the UAE. But with tapping our renewable energy resources, we will be energy exporter in the near future.
Because you recently signed a deal with New Fortress Energy to develop an offshore LNG terminal. How important is LNG and gas to Sri Lanka's future energy mix?
Well, as I mentioned earlier, we are very late. Right now, we don't have a single power station using LNG, or we don't use LNG in our transport or domestic sector. Therefore, we consider natural gas as our transitional energy, because right now we have identified our confirmed gas reserves in our offshore. Therefore, whatever we use, coal and petroleum, gas oil, then other oils to produce power, will be replaced firstly with natural gas. That's why, as the first measure, New Fortress Energy will supply, they have entered into a contract with the Sri Lankan government to supply LNG, but for a limited time. Thereafter, it will be replaced with our own gas reserves.
You obviously have your 2050 target to become net zero. How do you balance the need to reduce emissions and achieve that target with the responsibility to ensure that there's sustainable economic and social development?
Well, there is a myth that when we are going to emphasize on the renewable energy, the poorest sector of the society would be ignored or neglected. But it is not so. We have practiced this in Sri Lanka. When we are going to introduce rooftop solar panels, we were able to provide electricity to the people to whom we failed to provide the electricity from the national grid because of the it's beyond the economic to extend the national grid to those rural areas. Secondly, recently Sri Lanka launched a program to provide electricity for the poor people by gifting them rooftop solar panels. Then the people who can't afford the grid electricity can now have electricity thanks to rooftop solar panels. So renewable energy is not something that which excludes certain sections of the society, which is a very inclusive approach where we have taken into the power consumption the people who couldn't afford electricity before because of its high cost.
Wonderful. Thank you. Some wise words there. Thank you so much for joining us here on LNG TV, and enjoy the rest of GasTech.
Thank you. Thank you very much for the opportunity.